فاشرف بي لاشتغالي بالعلم ولا تبغي به ما عشت يا ذا بدلا ويا له من شرف عظيم.
الحمد لله رب العالمين، له الحمد الحسن والثناء الجميل، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، يقول الحق وهو يهدي السبيل، وأشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا محمد صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه والتابعين لهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين. أما بعد، we are still in the sharh and the explanation of the book كتاب الصفات للإمام الدارقطني رحمه الله. We finished the chapter إثبات القدمين لله, affirming two foot for Allah تبارك وتعالى. And the chapter that we're going to be starting today is إثبات اليدين لله, affirming for Allah سبحانه وتعالى two hands. So we're going to affirm for Allah تبارك وتعالى two hands. And صفة اليد, this characteristics يد is from the صفات ذاتية. It is a صفة ذاتية. And Allah تبارك وتعالى الصفات are either صفة فعلية or صفة ذاتية. صفات ذاتية are characteristics that are not connected to Allah's will, meaning they are always attached to Him سبحانه وتعالى. Whereas في صفات فعلية, on the other hand, are characteristics that are connected to Allah's will. He does them when He wants, and He doesn't do when He doesn't want it, سبحانه وتعالى. Like صفة النزول, for instance, Allah descending, is a صفة فعلية. You see? Because it's connected to Allah's will. Allah is not descending all the time. He's descending, subhanahu wa ta'ala, when He wants to descend. You see, He descends when he wants to descend, subhanahu wa ta'ala. As for sifatul yad, which we're going to be speaking about, is connected to Allah tabarak wa ta'ala's dhat. لا تنفك عن ذات الله تبارك وتعالى. It's never detached from Allah is that, subhanahu wa ta'ala. So it's not something Allah will have sometimes and he wouldn't have it at other times, or He wouldn't be doing it at other times. Okay? This characteristic, sifatul yadain, we affirm it for Allah, just like we affirm all the other characteristics for Allah, tabarak wa ta'ala. And the way we do it, we spoke about it, is what? مِنْ غَيْرِ تَحْرِيفٍ وَلَا تَعْطِيلٍ وَمِنْ غَيْرِ تَكِيفٍ وَلَا تَمْثِيلٍ. This is our belief. And we affirm it because we find it in the Qur'an and the Sunnah. If we look at the Quran, if we look at the Sunnah, we find that Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala has these characteristics, al-yad. So first of all, we have to understand the meaning of the word yad. What does yad mean? In the language, the word yad has so many meanings. It has what? It has a lot of meanings. But the ma'na that it comes back to, the meaning in which it comes back to, all of those meanings, all those meaning come back to is one, which is al-maqbad. Al-maqbad. What does al-maqbad mean? It means grabbing. Al-Layth, he said in his Qamus, he says, yadul fa's, the yad of the fa's. The fa's is what? Huh? Axe, first. It is maqbaduha, is to grab it. وَيَدُ السَّيْفِ maqbaduhu. And the sword, the hand of the sword is the place to grab. وَمِنْهُ سُمِّيَتْ يَدُ الْبَابِ يَدًا. The door handle is called the hand, right? In the Arabic language, you say يَدُ الْبَابِ. Why? لِأَنَّ بِهَا, because it, يقبض ويد الإنسان سميت يدا لأن بها يقبض. So the door handle, the Arabs they call it a hand, the hand of the door handle. And so it's because you grab it, and the hand is called a hand because you grab with it. Okay, إذن the معنى in the Arabic language it comes back to this, whether it be سواء كان يقبض أو يقبض. What are the evidences that Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala has a hand? The Quran, Sunnah, mention it. Allah says, for example, in Surah Al-Ma'idah, ayah 64, Allah says, وَقَالَتِ الْيَهُودُ يَدُ اللَّهِ مَغْلُولَةٌ غُلَّتْ أَيْدِيهِمْ وَلُعِنُوا بِمَا قَالُوا بَلْ يَدَاهُ مَبْسُوطَتَانِ يُنْفِقُ كَيْفَ يَشَاءُ. Ayah 64, Allah says in this ayah, وَقَالَتِ الْيَهُودُ, the Jews, they said, يَدُ اللَّهِ, the hand of Allah. Very good. The hand of Allah. That's in Surah Sad. Surah Sad. Ayah 75. Allah says, مَا مَنَعَكَ أَن تَسْجُدَ لِمَا خَلَقْتُ بِيَدَيَّ. Iblis, what prevented you or prohibited you from or stopped you from prostrate? لِمَا خَلَقْتُ بِيَدَيَّ, that which I have created with my two hands. What's stopping you from prostrating to a creation which I have created with my two hands? Also Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala, He says, أَوَلَمْ يَرَوْا أَنَّا خَلَقْنَا لَهُمْ مِمَّا عَمِلَتْ أَيْدِينَا أَنْعَامًا. أَوَلَمْ يَرَوْا, do they not see? أَنَّا خَلَقْنَا لَهُمْ, that we created for them, مِمَّا عَمِلَتْ أَيْدِينَا, that which our hands have done, أَنْعَامًا, blessing for them. أَيْدِينَا, our hands, Allah says. تَبَارَكَ الَّذِي بِيَدِهِ الْمُلْكُ. The first ayah, Surah Al-Mulk. And أَوَلَمْ يَرَى الْإِنسَانُ أَنَّا خَلَقْنَا لَهُمْ مِمَّا عَمِلَتْ أَيْدِينَا. It is Surah Yasin, ayah 71. Are you with me? Also the hadith of the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام. Also the hadith of the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام. Hadith Abu Musa al-Ash'ari رضي الله تعالى عنه, which he said, إِنَّ اللَّهَ تَعَالَى يَبُسُطُ يَدَهُ بِالْلَّيْلِ لِيَتُوبَ مُسِيءُ النَّهَارِ وَيَبْسُطُ يَدَهُ بِالنَّهَارِ لِيَتُوبَ مَسِيءُ اللَّيْلِ حَتَّى تَطْلُعَ الشَّمْسُ مِنْ مَغْرِبِهَا. So we have in this hadith, إِنَّ اللَّهَ تَعَالَى, verily Allah, يَبْسُطُ يَدَهُ بِاللَّيْلِ, Allah opens, سبحانه وتعالى, the word opens. What does Allah تبارك وتعالى open? يَدَهُ بِاللَّيْلِ, He opens His hand at night. لِيَتُوبَ مُسِيءُ النَّهَارِ وَيَبْسُطُ يَدَهُ بِالنَّهَارِ, and he also opens his hand in the daytime. We have hand here. Also the well-known hadith al-Shafa'ah, which is in Sahihain. The previous hadith Abu Musa al-Ash'ari in Sahih Muslim. This one's in what? Sahihain Bukhari and Muslim. Which Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala, He says, فَيَأْتُونَهُ فَيَقُولُ يَا آدَمْ. The people come to Adam and they will say to him, يَا آدَمْ أَنْتَ أَبُو الْبَشَرِ, you are the father of the humans. خَلَقَكَ اللَّهُ بِيَدِهِ, Allah created you with His hands. وَنَفَخَ فِيكَ مِنْ رُوحِهِ, and Allah blew His soul into you. Yeah? And Allah blew His what? His soul into you. وَنَفَخَ فِيكَ مِنْ رُوحِهِ. Also in hadiths that Imam Dharqutni is going to bring them. يَدُ اللَّهِ مَلْآ لَا يَغِيظُهَا نَفَقَةٌ وَبِيَدِهِ الْأُخْرَى الْمِيزَانُ يَخْفِضُ وَيَرْفَعُ. Allah's hand is full, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Giving it does not decrease what Allah has, what He has. So Allah's hand is full, subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَبِيَدِهِ الْأُخْرَى الْمِيزَانُ, and with His other hand is the scale. يَخْفِضُ وَيَرْفَعُ. يَخْفِضُ وَيَرْفَعُ. He puts some people down, subhanahu wa ta'ala, and He raises a people. Al-Imam al-Shafi'i rahimahullah, he says, لله تبارك وتعالى أسماء وصفات. Allah has names and He has characteristics. جاء بها كتابه, the book of Allah has come with these characteristics. Allah mentions them, states them in His book. وأخبر بها نبيه, and His prophet also states these characteristics. صلى الله عليه وسلم أمته, He informed them of His ummah. صلوات الله وسلم عليه. And from them is أنه سميع, that Allah is the all here. وأن له يدين, and that Allah has two hands. Are you there? وأن له يدين. بقوله, based on the verse, بَلْ يَدَاهُمَ بُسُوطَتَانِ, that both of the hands of Allah are open. And Imam Shafi'i says this. وَأَنَّ لَهُ يَمِينًا, and that Allah has a right. بقوله, وَالسَّمَاوَاتُ مَطْوِيَّاتٌ بِيَمِينِهِ. Allah has hands and two hands, and that He has a right one, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Ibn Khuzaybah rahimahullah, the same one of Imam Shafi'i, Ibn Abi Ya'la brings in طبقات الحنابلة. First volume, page 280, 82. Ibn Khuzaymah says the following: Babu ذكر إثبات اليد للخالق البارئ جل وعلا والبيان أن الله تعالى له يدان كما أعلمنا في محكم تنزيله. إمام الأئمة ابن خزيمة رحمه الله. He says Babu chapter ذكر إثبات اليد. This chapter is affirming for Allah تبارك وتعالى a hand, the creator, البارئ جل وعلا. والبيان and also clarifying أن الله تعالى له يدان and that Allah has two hands. كما أعلمنا في محكم تنزيله as he has told us in his Quran. And then what he does is Ibn Khuzaymah رحمه الله, he brings all of the evidences for that. He brings ayat and evidences to prove that. And then after that, what he says is Ibn Khuzaymah after he says رحمه الله تعالى باب ذكر البيان من سنة النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم. That was from the Quran, right? He brings all the ayats. Then he goes to باب ذكر البيان من سنة النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم. Now bringing it from the prophetic sunnah, from the prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام, على إثبات يد الله جل وعلا, affirming for Allah a hand. You see, موافقا لما تلونا من تنزيل ربنا لا مخالفا, in support of that which we have read from the Quran. So the hadith is affirming what's in the Quran. قد نزه الله نبيه وعلى درجته ورفع قدره عن أن يقول إلا ما هو موافق لما أنزل الله عليه من وحي. When the Prophet ﷺ is purified and he's protected from, and his status is too high for him to state something that is not in accordance to the Quran. Meaning the Sunnah is only affirming what the Quran has already affirmed in Allah tabarak wa ta'ala's characteristics. Abu Musa, Abu al-Hasan al-Ash'ari, the great scholar, Abu al-Hasan al-Ash'ari, who repented from the belief of the current Asha'ira today. He has repented from that current belief. And he died upon the belief of Imam Ahmad, as he is clearly stated in his three of his works, Risalatu ilaha al-Thagr, also in his kitab al-Ibana fi usul al-Diyana, and also in kitab Maqalatul Islamiyin. But in this book of his, Risalatu ilaha al-Thagr, look what he says. He says, وَأَجْمَعُوا, unanimous agreement, إِجْمَعُ عَلَىٰ أَنَّهُ عَزَّ وَجَلَّ يَسْمَعُ, that Allah hears, وَيَرَىٰ, and that Allah sees, وَأَنَّ لَهُ تَعَالَىٰ يَدَيْنِ مَبْسُوطَتَيْنِ, and that Allah has two hands that are what? Open. Are you with me? From the Asha'ira today, they claim, they affirm the characteristics of hearing, right? Are you with me? They affirm the characteristics of hearing, but they don't affirm the characteristics of listening, of what you call it, hands. The two hands of Allah. Abu al-Hasan al-Ash'ari mentioned them both in the same context. That's the way you affirm the sami', the hearing, you should also affirm that. You should affirm the hands of Allah tabarak wa ta'ala. Abu Bakr al-Isma'ili, a great Shafi'i scholar of hadith, he has a book called I'tiqadu A'immat al-Hadith. He says, وَخَلَقَ اللَّهُ آدَمَ عَلَيْهِ السَّلَامُ بِيَدِهِ, Allah created Adam with his hands. وَيَدَاهُ مَبْسُوطَتَانِ يُنْفِقُ كَيْفَ يَشَاءُ, and Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, his hands are open, he gives as he wills, bila i'tiqadi kayfa yada, without believing how the hands are. We don't believe the how, because we don't know it. إِذْ لَا يَنْطِقْ كِتَابُ اللَّهِ تَعَالَى فِيهِ بِكَيْفِ, because Allah's Qur'an hasn't uttered and has not stated how to the characteristics of Allah tabarak wa ta'ala. قَوَامُ السُّنَّةِ أَبُو قَاسِمَ التَّيْمِيُّ وَالْأَصْبَهَانِيُّ رَحِمَهُ اللَّهِ, in his great book, Al-Hujjah fi Bayani al-Mahajjah, he says, Faslun, chapter, fi ithbati al-yadi lillahi ta'ala sifatan lahu, affirming hand for Allah tabarak wa ta'ala as a characteristic of his. And then he brought ayat to affirm this. And then after that he goes, after he's brought all the ayat, then he goes, ذِكْرُ الْبَيَانِ مِنْ سُنَّةِ النَّبِي صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ عَلَىٰ إِثْبَاتِ الْيَدِ مُوَافِقًا لِلْتَنْزِيلِ. And then he goes, affirming and stating evidences from the prophetic sunnah, from the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, in affirming a hand for Allah tabarak wa ta'ala in accordance to the Quran. And then he brings a hadith from his chain to the Prophet alayhi salatu wa sallam. Shaykh al-Islam Ibn Taymiyyah in his Majmu' al-Fatawa, 6th volume, page 263, he says, إِنَّ لِلَّهِ تَعَالَى يَدَيْنِ مُخْتَصَّتَيْنِ, Allah has two hands that are uniquely for him alone. ذاتي, ذاتيني, ذاتي, ذاتيتين سوري. إن لله تعالى يدين مختصتين به ذاتيتين له كما يليق بجلاله. Allah has two hands that are uniquely for him alone, that are also from his ذاتيه. له كما يليق بجلاله, as it befits his majesty, as it befits his majesty. Now that we've affirmed from all those ayat and hadith, and also from the aqwal of a'immat sunnah rahimahumullah jami'an, and these are the great books of aqidah books, al-hujjah fi bayan al-muhajjah by Abu Qasim al-Taymi, i'tiqad a'immat al-hadith by Abu Bakr al-Isma'ili rahimahullah, al-imam al-Shafi'i in his statement rahimahullah from a'immat sunnah that Abu Ya'la brings in his tabaqat al-hanabila, you see Shaykh al-Islam ibn Taymiyyah min a'immat sunnah, who's well known. So he hasn't come with anything. Abu al-Hassan al-Ash'ari, in his own book, Risalat ila Ahli Thaghar, he also states this. So these statements that these a'immas said is all that Ibn Taymiyyah and the likes of him has said from a'immat al-Sunnah. Here's an issue that we need to now remember now. Are you with me, brothers? When I was given the ayat, okay, when I was given the nusus, the ayat especially, what I done was, I gave ayat that stated for Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala sometimes a hand for him, and sometimes two hands, and sometimes hands, plural. So the nusus, the text, especially the Quran, okay, when it came to affirming Allah's character, Allah, this characteristics of his, which is al-yad, sometimes it came as ja'at bil-ifrad, it came singular. Wa marratan bil-tathniyah, and sometimes it comes as dual. Wa marratan bil-jam'i, and sometimes it has come what? Plural. For example, mithal al-ifrad is تبارك الذي بيده, Allah's hand, بيده. Okay. ومثال التثنية, when it came dual, is what? لما خلقت بيدي, I created Adam with my two hands. And it is also coming plural, which is the أولي سورة ياسين. Allah تبارك وتعالى says أولم يرى الإنسان أنا خلقنا لهم مما عملت أيدينا أنعاما فهم لها مالكون. أيدينا plural. So now the question is that this here right now, two points we need to look at it as. One is the fact, pay attention, this is a very powerful point, the fact that these ayat have stated, they have stated these characteristics al-yad for Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala in different ways, actually shows us that it is a sifatul haqiqiyah. This is a literal characteristics. This tanawwu, these differences in one time being singular, one time becoming two, one time becoming plural, are you with me? Is basically a evidence that necessitates affirming this characteristic for Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala ala haqiqatihi in his haqiqa way. That's one point. The second point that needs to be looked at when we look at it is what? هل بين هذه النصوص تعارض? Is there any contradiction between these texts? These texts, the one time it's saying singular, one is saying dual, and one is saying plural. هل بين هذه النصوص تعارض? Is there تعارض between these نصوص? No, we say ليس بينهم تعارض. There is no contradiction between them. You know why? Pay attention. I want you to be with me here, because we have to understand. We don't just want to. We are now going to apply the knowledge that we learned from Usul al-Fiqh and Mustalah al-Hadith and all of that to get to understand this aqidah of ours. Look what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says. In the beginning, and I gave one example for Ifrad. What was the example that I gave for the singular? Surah al-Mulk. Tabaraka alladhi biyadihi al-mulku. This qa'idah is, the qa'idah is, if a singular, it is attributed. What does it show? مفرد المضاف, what is it? أي مفرد بيده, Allah's hand. What does it show in the Arabic language? If it's attributed or it's ascribed. For example, وَإِن تَعُدُّوا نِعْمَةَ اللَّهِ. Yeah. It shows generalization, it shows jam'a, there's no restriction to it anymore. It becomes unrestricted. صحيح؟ Are you with me? This is what we learn in Qawa'id al-Usul al-Fiqh. Sahih? والمفرد والمفرد إذ يضافه when the mufrad is made mudaf, what does it show? It's from those things that are like the shartiya and the mawsula and the nakirat, when they, you know, those siyaq that shows generalization, this is also from it. So when we say biyadihi is unrestricted, it's plural, right? Unrestricted is plural. And we have the plural, which is amilat aidina. Are they together, both of them? Of course. Amilat aidina is plural. Biyadihi is now, it takes a meaning of plural, that is plural, so they're together on one side now. Now pay attention. We have here now the ifrad and the jama'. We say la yanfiyani, they don't go against each other. Sahih? Good. The question that arises is now that you've got both of those, singular and the plural, at one place. You brought them together and you said, okay, this is generalization. What about this, the dual? What about the dual? There's two answers for that now. We say that the jama' la yunafi tathniyati aydan. There's also not a contradiction between the dual and the plural that you have here. You don't have no singular anymore. Are you with me? You have no singular. The singular is mudaf, it becomes jama', so it takes the jama'. Sahih? Very good. We only have now al jama'. And we have dual. Do they both contradict one another? No, they don't contradict one another. The reason why they contradict is two answers. You have to always remember these two answers. The reason why they don't is because, is dual nasun fil adad? In other words, the dual, pay attention, this is very important. Can plural be restricted, narrowed down, like the dual can? For instance, if I say to you, Wallahi, we respect you a lot, method to somebody. Does it mean here out of royalty, or does it mean more than one? Ihtimal. It can take both of those meanings. But if I say both of us respect you, can it have any other meaning except other than two people? إِذَنَّهُ nas. The dual is a nas. It's restricted for only one meaning, the two. Whereas the plural is an unrestricted. Sahih? Good. In the we, still the first point, since it's not unrestricted, are you there? Can the two be part of it? Yes. Can we bring the two into it? Na'am qad yakun. The two can fall under it. That's one qawl of the ulama. That's one response. The other response is that أَلَمْ يَرَى الْإِنسَانَ أَنَّا خَلَقْنَاهُ مِنْ أَوَلَمْ يَرَى الْإِنسَانَ أَنَّا خَلَقْنَاهُ مِمَّا عَمِلَتْ أَيْدِينَا أَنْعَامًا. They say, the scholars, they said, the jama' here only came مِنْ بَابِ الْمُنَاسَبَةِ. That's it. The jama' here is not intended. And the Arabs do that. When they speak, they speak in a plural way with something they don't intend for it to be plural because of the context. And Allah did it in the Quran. إِن تَتُوبَ إِلَى اللَّهِ, if you both repent to Allah, Hafsa and Aisha, فَقَدْ صَغَتْ قُلُوبُكُمَا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying قُلُوب. He should have said قَلْبَكُمَا. I'm قَلْبَاكُمَا, both of your hearts. Qulub here is plural. And it's in Tatuba ila Allah, he is talking about the two hearts of who? Hafsa and Aisha. The jama' here came, some scholars they say, min babi tasheel, is to make it either simple because it's easy to say it. Qulubukuma, it's easy to say it. Or is what I just said to you, which is what? The jama' here came min babi al munasabati bayna al mudafi wal mudafun ilayh. There's a relationship. So it just goes just to go with the same flow. Sahih. So amilat aidina, because the word aidina is being brought back to a dhamir which is jama', from that angle it became what? Min bab al munasabah. This is the thing. The ulama, they said, in tatuba ila Allah faqad sagat qulubukuma, the heart here is brought back to Hafsa, and it's still be jama'. How about the one that's been brought back to a jama'? It's got more right for it to be jama', sahih. If what is being brought back to is a jama', are you there? It has more rights for the word to become jama'. Because in tatuba ila Allah faqad sagat qulubukuma is a dhamir a'idun ila tathniyah. It's going back to two, but it's still being made into jama'. Araftum? Are you with me? Now this is something we can look into later. But this point is very important to understand. Are you with me? So the Arabs do that. The Quran has that examples. So the word mimma amilat aydina, that's why it's being plural. Araftum? So that's one thing we have to understand. So now we're left with only the tathniyah, and it is an adadun fi nasi. We take that. We take it. We give it a ruling. Very good. Another thing that, and this qa'idah you need to memorize. When it comes to Allah tabarak wa ta'ala's characteristics, the hand, Allah's two hands, because it has come in more than one way, in more than one usage, it can't mean except a literal meaning, haqiqa meaning. Are you with me, brothers? For example, sometimes we have the word qabd. Allah uses the word qabd. Sometimes Allah uses the word bast. Sometimes Allah uses the word infaq. Sometimes Allah tabarak wa ta'ala uses the word tay. Sometimes you have the word imsak. Sometimes akhth Allah used. Sometimes Allah mentions that He created with His hand. Sometimes Allah uses His writ with His hand. Sometimes Allah tabarak wa ta'ala says He uses the word gharas, planting. Sometimes Allah taqlib. Sometimes Allah uses hathu. Sometimes He uses haz. Sometimes He uses hamal. All of these meanings are used for Allah tabarak wa ta'ala. And they are characteristics of the hand. And the fact that these usage have come in the Nusus al-Kitab al-Sunnah, what does it make? يَجْعَلُهَا نَصًا قَطْعِيًا لَا يَحْتَمِلُ الْمَجَازَ وَالتَّأْوِيلَ. It can't be majaz and ta'wil anymore. You can't do ta'wil to it, nor can you go in the path of majaz. That's inqila bil-majaz, if that we accept the idea of majaz. And if we accept the idea of at-ta'wil. For example, let's look at the word qabd. Allah says in Surah Zumar, ayah 67, Allah says, وَمَا قَدَرُ اللَّهَ حَقَّ قَدْرِهِ وَالْأَرْضُ جَمِيعًا قَبْضَتُهُ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ قَبْضَتُهُ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ. Also Allah tabarak wa ta'ala uses the word bast. He says, بَلْ يَدَاهُ مَبْسُوطَتَانِ. Bast. Surah Al-Ma'idah, ayah 64, that Allah tabarak wa ta'ala's hands are open. You see, even the hadith that I just brought right now, which is Sahih Muslim, hadith Abu Musa al-Ash'ari. إن الله ترى الله تبارك وتعالى يبسط يده بالليل ليتوب مسيء النهار ويبسط يده بالنهار ليتوب مسيء الليل. يبسط إنفاق is used as well. بل يداه مبسوطتان ينفق. He gives كيف يشاء as he wishes. We have the word الطي والسماوات مطويات بيمينه rolled up. You see. We have the word إمساك holding back. You see, Allah is holding, subhanahu wa ta'ala, in the hadith Sahih Muslim, in the hadith of Abdullah ibn Mas'ud, radiallahu ta'ala anhu, that a rabbi, he came to the Prophet, he said, Ya Muhammad, or he said, Ya Abul Qasim, and he said to the Prophet, Inna Allah ta'ala yumsiku samawati, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He holds the samawat, the day of judgment on one finger, you see, and on the wal-aradin and the earth on one finger. So he holds the first part of the hadith mentions. This is what concerns us. We have the word akhd, Allah takes. The hadith Abu Huraira narrated that Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, He takes the sadaqah that you give, the good sadaqah that you put forward, and Allah nurtures it for you, subhanahu wa ta'ala. He nurtures it, you see, with His palm. So the word palm is also used, which we're going to touch on later. You see, we have khalq, Allah saying, I created with my hands, saying, قَالَ يَا إِبْلِيسُ مَا مَنَعَكَ أَن تَسْجُدَ لِمَا خَلَقْتُ بِيَدَيَّ. Allah is saying, I created with my hands. You see, we also have the hadith of Shafa'a, which is Sahihain. You see, which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, where the people say, يَا آدَمْ أَنْتَ أَبُو الْبَشَرِ. You are the father of mankind. خَلَقَكَ اللَّهُ بِيَدِي. Allah created you with His hand. Now pay attention here. This hadith, Hadith al-Shafa'a, خَلَقَكَ اللَّهُ بِيَدِي, shows this is a distinct characteristics of His only. Because if every single person, if it's blessing or if it's ni'mah or if it's qudra, then there's no significance for Adam. If you say that the yad means qudra, ability, then really we all created with Allah's ability. Sahih? To try to get Adam to help us, we'd have to give him something he's unique in. Sahih? So to say khalaqaka Allahu biyadi, and it means qudra or ni'mah. Are you there? Goes against the purpose of why we're trying to get Adam alayhi salam to help us. We have the kitabah that Allah tabarak wa ta'ala writ. The debate that took place between who? Adam and Musa. In Sahih al-Bukhari, in the hadith of Abu Hurairah. That the Prophet said, ihtajja Adam wa Musa. Adam and Musa had an argument. And Musa overcame Adam. Adam overcame Musa. فَقَالَ لَهُ مُوسَى Musa said to Adam alayhi salam, you are Adam and you are our father. And because of that, you forsaked us. And what you did is you took us out of Jannah. Because of you, we came out of Jannah. And then Nabiullah Adam said to Musa, اصطفاك الله بكلامه. Allah chose you with his words. You see, وخط لك بيده. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he drew for you with his hand. أتلوموني, are you going to hold me account? Meaning he writ for you. Allah writ with his hand. Are you going to hold me on what? على أمر قدره الله, something Allah destined سبحانه وتعالى قبل, before أن يخلقني بأربعين سنة, 40 years before I was, before I came into creation. And the Prophet said, فحج آدم وموسى. Three times the Prophet said. So what do you mean? What did he mean? He said Allah wrote it. He drew it with his hand, writ it سبحانه وتعالى. Are you with me? The word غرس, to plant something, was also used in the hadith which is Sahih Muslim. Also the hadith of Taqlib, you see, which is in Bukhari, in hadith Abi Sa'id al-Khudri. Also tarbiyah, Allah nurturing something, subhanahu wa ta'ala. We have that. We also have the word, we have hath, we used in the hadith of Jami' al-Tirmidhi. In hadith Abu Umamah radiallahu ta'ala anhu. All of these are things. The word hathu is to throw something. Ramahu. It means this. All of these are to carry something. Allah ta'ala in the hadith which is in Muslim Imam Ahmad, hadith Abdullah ibn Sa'ud. So what I mean is this, all of these tanawwu', these different usage in the nusus shar'iyya, kitab and sunnah, it is what necessitates. So the qa'ida is tanawwu' nusus shar'iyyati fi ithbat al-yadi يستوجب إثبات اليد صفة لله حقيقة. The nusus coming in different usage in affirming the hand for Allah necessitate that this is a literal characteristic. The fact that he used all of those different ways. For example, the word kaf was used. The word asabi', fingers are used. Anamil is used, fingertips. Yameen is used, right hand. Are you with me? All of those usage of those words in the Nusus al-Wahyayn, you find it, Kitab al-Sunnah. What does it show? That this is what? It's characteristics for Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala. Here now is an issue that we need to look into. There's a question and an issue that we need to look into, which is, can we affirm for Allah a left hand? Ahlul Sunnah wal Jama'ah differed upon this issue. There's a khilaf amongst Ahlul Sunnah. Within Ahlul Sunnah, ulama Ahlul Sunnah wal Jama'ah, this issue, they have a khilaf regarding it. There are two views. Some scholars who say, we affirm left and right. Are you with me? And those who are Al-Imam Uthman ibn Sa'id Ad-Darimi rahimahullah, Abu Ya'la Al-Farra, Siddiq Hassan Khan, Muhammad Khalil Al-Harras, and also the author of this, also the muhaqqiq of this kitab that we're reading right now, Al-Sheikh Abdullah ibn Muhammad Al-Wunayman. And they have their evidences which they have. The other group who believe no, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, both of his hands are right and there's no left, is Ibn Khuzaymah rahimahullah. إمام أحمد رحمه الله، الإمام البيهقي رحمه الله، الإمام الألباني رحمه الله. All of those believe what? That both of the hands are what? Both of the hands of Allah tabarak wa ta'ala are right. What is it that they both use? What is the argument on both sides? And the evidences that they all put forward. So we're going to start with the evidence of the first group of scholars. And then we're going to mention the second. And then inshallah ta'ala, whatever we see to be correct and authentic is what we're going to choose from those two opinions. But there is an khilaf amongst Ahlul Sunnati wal Jama'ah in this particular issue. The hadith that they use, the first party of scholars, is as follows.